What I want to do in this video is introduce you to a for loop. And we're going to do this by writing a little program that calculates the factorial of a number. In case you don't remember what a factorial of a number does, if I were to tell you what 1 factorial, and you normally write it as 1 and then an exclamation mark like that. It literally just means, well, that will just evaluate to 1. If you say 2 factorial, that's going to be equal to 2 times 1. If you say 3 factorial, that's going to be equal to 3 times 2 times 1, and which is going to be equal to 6. And so if you have any number factorial, it's just going to be that number times one number less than that times one number less than that, all the way down to 1. So with that out of the way, let's implement our factorial program. And the way I'm going to do it is, it's going to take an input from the user. It's going to prompt the user to put a number that they want to take the factorial of, and then it's going to calculate the factorial. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a function that Python provides for us. And I'm using Python 2 in this video. You'd have to do it slightly different, actually. I'll talk about that in a second if you were using Python 3. Python 2 is what most implementations of Python are built in at the time of this video. But there is a Python 3 out there that's kind of a newer version. I clarify that about a bit in a future video. But anyway, we're going to take an input from the user, and we're going to prompt them with a message. And we're going to say, enter a non-negative integer to take the factorial of. And just so that we get familiarize ourselves with functions and all, we're passing an argument to the function. And the argument that we're passing to the function, to the input function right over here, is a string. And string sounds like a very complicated thing, but it really is just a string of characters. You can view it as a bunch of text. And it will present this text to the user, and it will give them a little input box. The user will put something in that input box. It will evaluate what's in that input box, and then you could either view it as have the variable number refer to it, or put it in the variable number, depending on how you want to visualize a variable. If you're using Python 3, you'll want to call a val on what's returned from this function. This is if you're doing Python 3. I'm running Python 2 right now. And if you want to do it exactly the way I'm doing it, I'm using the PyScripter IDE, Integrated Development Environment. It's free open source project on a PC. But there's many, many ways that you can edit Python. You could really just do it on any text editor. So anyway, so far all we've done is we've taken input from the user, and we're putting it in the variable number. And what's really cool about Python is we can just run this program as is and just see what happens. So let's do that. I'm going to save it, and I'm going to run it. This little play button runs it in this IDE. And just like we said, it prompts the user, enter a non-negative integer to take the factorial of. So I don't know, let me type in 10. And I type OK. Nothing happened. Well, of course nothing happened, because I didn't really tell this to do anything. But if we type in number, we'll see that it is now assigned to 10. The variable is now referring to the number 10. So now we can use this number and take the factorial of it. So what I'm going to do, and we're going to do it iteratively, and we're going to talk more about what that means in the future. So I'm going to define another variable called product. And I'm going to start product at 1. And what we're going to do is we're going to start from 1 up to whatever number this is, and keep multiplying the product by each successively larger number. So we're going to start. So I'm going to set up a for loop here. In the next video, I'm going to really step through exactly what a for loop does. But within the for loop, we're going to define a variable I. This is kind of the classic variable to define in for loops. And that's what that variable is going to keep incrementing to larger and larger values as we go through it. So for I in range. And for loops are in Python are a little bit different than if you were doing it in JavaScript or Java, and I'll do a future video where we do that. But range of number. And just to understand what range of number does is it provides a list of numbers starting with 0 up to 1 less than that number. So if we talk, so over here we already defined what number is. Number is 10. So if I type in range of 10, or let me do range of number, it gives me a list starting at 0 all the way to 9, all the way to 1 less than 10. So that's the same thing as range of 10. And what this for loop does is It assigns the I to each term of the sequence. So it starts with 1, or each term of this list. It starts with 1, and then it'll whatever you tell it to do in the for loop with I is equal to 1. Then it'll assign I to be 1. It'll start with I equals 0. Then it'll go to I equal 1, then I equals 2, then I equals 3, so on and so forth, all the way until you've gone all the way through the list. And so what we can do here is within the for loop, we can redefine product to be equal to the product, the former product. So our new product is going to be our old product times, and I'm going to multiply it times i plus 1. We're going to step through it carefully in the next video, but I want you to think about what it's doing already. So right when we start, let's say number ends up being 3. So product gets set to 1, and we say for I in range, and then if we do range of 3, then I is first going to be 0. And so we're going to take our old product, so 1, times I plus 1. Well, I is going to be 0. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So it's going to be 1 times 1 is going to be 1. Then we're going to assign I to be 1. This is what the for loop does. It iterates. It keeps incrementing. Well, it doesn't always have to increment, but it keeps changing the value of I as it goes through this list. And so the next time around, now product is 1, but now I is 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2 times 1 is now going to be 2. And then it'll set I to be 2. So now it's going to be 2 plus 1 times what product was from the last iteration, which was 2. And so it's going to be 2 times 3, which is 6. And so when we're finally done with this for loop, inside of product, or I guess we could say product will be referring to the actual factorial of the number inputted. So then we could say print product. And in Python, in this case right here, the interpreter knows to break out of this for loop once it runs out of numbers to assign I to. So that's why it doesn't run forever. So let's see if what we did here actually works. Let's see if it actually works. So let me write it like this. So let's see if this thing actually works. So I'll save it, and then let me run it. And so it's asking me enter a non-negative integer to take the factorial of. So let's try with 3. Enter. It gave me the right answer. Let's try it again. So enter a non-negative integer to take the factorial of. I don't know. Let's try something large. 10. It worked, assuming you could verify this for yourself. So what we've done here is write a very simple program, but it already does something neat. It takes a factorial of an arbitrary number. And in the next video, we're going to step through it much more carefully in case this kind of confused you, what this for loop did. So just hold with me for the next video and watch that, and that does a little bit more of a careful explanation.